Today, we're going to be talking about the trapezoidal rule. And using trapezoids to approximate the area is another way that we can approximate area under the curve instead of using our Riemann sums like we started doing in the beginning of the chapter. So remember, the area of a trapezoid is 1/2 the height times base 1 plus base 2. This is key that you understand that formula and you have that formula memorized. Myself and the AP, they're not going to give you that formula, so you need to know that formula. So approximate the area under the curve using trapezoids. What we're going to get to, guys, is we're getting to a why the formula is what it is. So let's call that the area of that first triangle. 1/2 my height times base 1, which is y sub 0 plus y sub 2. The next one, I'm sorry, y sub 1. The next one is 1/2 our height. And we're going to assume for now they all have equal heights. They're not always going to have equal heights. Y1 plus y2. So notice how we're duplicating on one of our bases. Now this one, area is 1/2 our height, y2 plus y3. And so on and so forth, all the way until you get to our last one, which is area is 1/2 our height, and our last one is y sub n minus 1, meaning this height here, one less than whatever our ending point was, plus y sub n. I don't know, and I don't know how many we're going to have, okay? So I have to add all these areas up together. What's common in each one of those areas? We have an h over a 2. All right, now let's look at what we have. We only have one y sub 0. We have two y sub 2s, or y sub 1s. We have two y sub 2s. We're going to have two y sub 3s, two y sub 4s. We double up on all of our bases until we get to our last one, this y sub 0, this one right here, the y sub n at the very end. I apologize, y sub n at the very end. We only have one of those. So the easy way that you guys could think about it is you have your height. Now, this is only if for equal heights. This is only if your heights are the same thing. Your height, remember, is going to be for these examples along the x-axis. This is only if you have equal heights. You could take h over 2 and take y0, the first base, the last base, just one of those, and multiply 2 times all the other bases to find your area. Okay? And this is just another way that they're explaining it. Okay? They have the height and they have dividing everything by 2. They factored out the h and then they factored out the 1/2 to get everything. I apologize if you stopped and started writing this down. You don't need to write this piece down because we've already talked about it. So, our trapezoidal rule. We can use a trapezoids to approximate area under the curve by using this formula, where a minus b is partitioned into this many subintervals, where h is that. Now, this is only if they are equal. Okay? If they're not equal, you're going to have to find each one specifically. Now, concave up. If I'm concave up, and let's talk about some extremes. So I'm just using some extremes here. If I'm concave up, the area times my x-axis here, by using that trapezoid, am I overestimating or underestimating? This overestimates the area, but might be a better approximation than a rectangle, because a rectangle would be down here. A rectangle could be up there. So trapezoids might give us a better idea, but this still overestimates. Versus concave down, when our curve is concave down to our x-axis, from here to here, connecting our points, concave down, this underestimates. Our area. Okay? Okay, use the trapezoidal rule with n equals 4 to approximate the value of the integral. Use the concavity of the function to predict whether approximation overestimates or underestimates. Okay, so let's look at this. We have x cubed, so 0, 0 at 1. I'm going to be at 1. At 2, I'm going to be all the way up at 8. So this is an idea of what our x cubed term looks like. Now I'm splitting this up into n equals 4. So our height is b minus a, 2 minus 0 over 4. So each one of them is worth a half. So our heights are each a half. So if you remember the formula that I gave you guys, it's one half the height divided by 2, our first function value. Okay, the first function value is actually 0. We have twice the next function value, which is f of one half. We have twice the next function value. And again, this only works. So that's this one. Again, this only works if you have equal subintervals. Plus our next function value, twice our next function value, would be 3/2. Plus just one of our last value, which is f of 2. Okay? So, plugging all that in, we get 1/4 on the outside, and we have a 1/4 plus a 2 plus a 27 over 4 plus an 8. So that's going to be 17 over 4. Now they ask me to determine. Is it an overestimate or an underestimate? Is this graph concave up or concave down? It's concave up, so this is an overestimate. So now that we know it's an overestimate, they ask us to use the integrals to find the exact value. So the integral would be 1/4 x to the fourth, evaluated from 0 to 2. When I plug in 2, I get 1/4 times by 2 to the 4th minus 1/4 times by 0 to the 4th. So this is going to simplify to be 4. So the actual area under our curve is 4. Using our trapezoids, we estimated it to be 17 over 4. This was an overestimation of the actual area. Okay, the second example. And this is what you see a lot on the AP, is they're going to give you a chart of values and use it to approximate the tra use your trapezoidal rule to approximate the area under the curve. What you want to check is make sure that you have even intervals. If you have even intervals, you can use a shortcut. If each one of these intervals is the same distance apart. If they're not, then you have to go about it the long way. So, those are 2 units apart. Those are 2 units apart. 2 units apart. Two. Two. So we have each one of those is 2 units apart, and they're 6 different intervals. So we could just use our one half. Our height is 2, the difference between each one of those. And then all you have to do, these are all your function values. So your first base, this is y sub 0. This is y sub n. So you just take one of those And then it's two times all of the other ones. Okay, so when I type all that in my calculator, I get 135. Okay, and that's just an approximation. Remember, we're just approximating when we're using our trapezoids. Okay, our next example. Use the accompanying table that gives the speeds and miles per hour at various times for a test rocket that was fired upward from the surface of the Earth. Use these values to approximate the number of miles traveled during the first 180 seconds. So if I have to figure out the distance, figure out number of miles or distance, that's the integral of velocity. Write your answer to the nearest tenth of a mile. Okay, so let's hope these are equal intervals. Intervals in between there is 20. There, it's 40. There, it's 30. There, it is 30 also. So there it's 20, and there we're 40. So you can't use our shortcut. You have to find the area of each one individually. So the area using the trapezoid of these two pieces. Okay, what's the difference between them? That's going to be your height, which is 1/2. My height is 20. Base 1 is 0.0. Base 2 is 0.03. I multiply all that together and I get 0.3. Now we need to find the area in between those. Okay, so that's 1/2. Your height is the difference between those, which is 40. Then we have base 1, base 2. Multiplying those together, we get 2.2. The next one, between these. So the difference again is 30, base 1 plus base 2, and I get 3.6. The next one, differences between those two. So I have 1/2. My height is going to be 30. Base 1 is 0.16 plus 0.27. And this ends up being 6.45. Next one. Between these two, we have 1/2. The height is 20. Base 1, 27, make sure you're writing them out right, plus base 2. And you might want to show your work on this just in case on the AP, if they're giving you some sort of credit for all of this work being shown, then you can say, you could see where you made your mistake. And then our last one, that might be hard to see, I tried to do each one in a different color. 1/2, the height is 40. Base 1 is 0.42. Base 2 is 0.65 equals that one was 21.4. So now we add all those together because that's going to give me my total area to get 40.85. They want it to the nearest tenth, so that's 40.9 miles. Okay? And that's our answer. And this is one where we didn't have equal heights. Each one of these heights was different, so you had to break it down into individual answers. Okay, that's it for today. Please make sure your lesson summary is submitted on time.